And there's a comprehensive guide to the forthcoming series, complete with profiles of the game's leading players in the BBC Ashes 93 magazine.
Least on tonight's batting order, the second test at Lord's.
Darling falls a victim to verity, caught by Sutcliffe at fine leg for a duck. McCabe succumbs to a slip catch by Hammond off verity. They lose O'Reilly, bowled by verity. And then the last wicket goes, Wall caught by Hendron. A wonderful day's cricket for verity, 15 wickets, and so England win by innings and 38 runs.
Well, that was 1934, a wonderful victory for England, and astonishingly, it's the last time England have beaten Australia at Lord's, 1934 and Verity's match. Well, welcome to the highlights of the first day of this Cornhill Test match at Lord's, the second in the series. The Australians won up, having won so convincingly at Old Trafford. Conditions for the game were quite good at the start of play. The ground staff had to work very, very hard right through the night. There was torrential rain in London. The ground was soaked yesterday with pools of water on it. They did a terrific job. Well, here's the toss now. Tony Lewis is out in the centre of the ground, and he has with him Alan Border and Graham.
So how's it going, Ricky?
We'll bat first.
Morning, Alan. Won the toss? Yes. Any hesitation at all?
A little bit. I mean, with the weather conditions over the last few days, there might be a little bit of juice there, but it does look as though might be a bit of turn later on in the game. As it progresses and wears a bit, and we've played two spinners, so hopefully it's the right decision.
So you're batting?
We're batting first, yeah.
Graham, what about the England side?
We just brought in Neil Foster for Philip Defratis in the last team. Otherwise the same.
Yep. And Neil Foster, quite a comeback for him, really?
Yeah, he's been a quality bowler for England over the years. He's had his injury problems, but he's standing okay this year. We obviously hope he has a good comeback match.
There'd be a lot of talk about England fighting back. Do you think that's possible?
Well, Test cricket is a hard game, and nothing's given to you. You've got to fight for what you want, and you know, we need to get back into the series, so we need a good performance.
And the two teams for this historic game, England led by Gooch with Alex Stewart as the keeper, have Atherton, Gatting, Smith, Hick, Lewis, Foster, Caddick, Such and Tufnell. The Australians' Border is skipper, and Healy is playing. He has a cracked bone in his finger, but he is definitely playing. Taylor, Slater, Boone, Mark Waugh, Steve Waugh, May comes into the side for Brendan Julian, the Hughes, Warne and McDermott, and the umpires, Mervyn Kitchen and David Shepherd, two West Country men, to confirm the Australians won the toss and they're batting. And there is a third umpire. Chris Balderstone is the man. He will be in the pavilion with the television set and no doubt with a few nerves jangling as well. The first time it's been tried in England has been tried in other countries. We join play now with the first ball of the second over. Neil Foster is the bowler, Michael Slater taking strike, and so far no runs are on the board. Michael Slater is taking strike, and so far no runs are on the board.
Well, not the comeback you'd have wanted. Slow outfield, otherwise that would certainly have raced away. It's still got there. That boundary always looks shorter, but the slope there takes the ball on its way.
First runs from Caddick, first runs for Taylor. Caddick. Nicely timed and
such again.
Yes, you have those sort of mornings, and Peter Such is certainly having one this morning. Every time the ball's hit past the infielders, he's the one that's doing the chasing. Doesn't seem to be moving all that freely, in fact. He seems to be limping a little. Whether that's his natural walk, Jack, or a worry for the captain, I don't know.
Now, that could have been back on the stumps. It was a desperate cry of watch from the non-striker, but just a feeling that ball was past the stumps before Slater knew.
Well, again, good line. Slightly inside edge, down onto floor, and the spin just taking it past that off stump.
Oh, well, that's the nearest thing we've seen, but unlucky for Foster to concede four. But that's the line that Ray Illingworth was on about. Was a delivery which all but got through. On a quicker wicket it might have done, and Slater caught for once on the back foot.
Yeah, so the ball not really running for England at the moment. Two or three good deliveries have been bowled. In fact, that didn't seam in. It seamed out, if anything, and still managed to get an out inside edge.
David Boone on the left, Alan Border waving.
Didn't pick it up all that quickly, but I'd have thought a sliding, diving, clutching, desperate attempt there might have been worthwhile.
Well, certainly members of the public thought that fine leg, I think it was Neil Foster, should have made a bit more of an aggressive effort to take a catch.
Good shot. He's played well this morning, Michael Slater. Now feels a bit quicker at the pavilion end. It's slow down towards the nursery end. And that's a good stroke. The significance of the flags at half-mast here at Lord's today. A tribute to the late Lindsay Hassett, who passed away in Australia yesterday. Captain of Australia over here in 1953, fine skipper. Well, perhaps the next one will be delivered with a little more pace from Carrick.
Well, this is just short of a length, and at that pace it's a lollipop delivery on this slow surface.
Stroke. That'll be slowed up by the outfield. Looks so there's a wet patch down there. Ball really did slow just before that Cornhill sign. 50 up, and that is a terrific start for the Australians. They won the toss and batted. There's moisture under the surface of the pitch. And Slater and Taylor have put on 50, and we're into the 15th over.
Straight away we saw there a little bit of indecision from the batsman, a bit of turn. You see, that's what you want. You want a good ball early on. Just keep a few thoughts in the batsman's head that it's not quite so easy playing the spinner.
Well, straight away, Tufnell right on the spot, and there's some spin there. Nothing much for Peter Such the first over, but certainly that delivery turn certainly straightened. That's beautifully played. Seemed a bit of a labour out there for Robin Smith. Four runs were run. Beautifully played. Oh, beautiful, beautiful footwork. It was a no ball as well, so that ball must have gone up. And Mark Taylor, perfect execution. Probably just heard the shout of no ball as the ball floated down towards him. It was on the way, plenty of width of the shot, and hammered through the covers. And again, played on width with a shortish and beautifully played. Mark Taylor got 124 in the first test match at Old Trafford in his first innings. Terrific professional player, massive concentration and a wide range of strokes too. There we have a false stroke.
Well, plenty of movement there for Chris Lewis. Pitched outside of stump, but it certainly climbed and moved away up the hill.
And that's 50. Of 83 balls, and there have been six fours, and that's been a splendid innings. That's a beautifully timed shot. Brings up the 100. What a quality partnership that's been. Slater's dominated it, but Taylor's helped him to do that. Rotated the strike nicely. Well, movement there to start with. First ball from Graham Gooch, and look, the swing there.
One more run added to take the Australian total to 101 for no wicket at lunch. Two extras in that total, with Slater a splendid 63 and Mark Taylor 36. An outstanding partnership once again from that pair. And the bowling figures for England, nothing in the right-hand column. Foster had 39 taken from 11, and Gooch, just before lunch, bowled a one over for one run and swung the ball a prodigious amount. We join play after lunch now in the fifth over. 10 runs have been added. Lewis is the bowler and Taylor is taking strike.
That's fine stroke. The upfield is just a little slow here, which is understandable because of yesterday's torrential rain. But it's slower down the nursery end. Once again, Gooch has gone past the outside edge.
Well, this is beautifully bowled. Look how he draws the batsman wide. That's a little bit wide at Lord's, down the slope.
That's a big hit. Takes Taylor to 50.
Well, Gooch's ball pretty steady. That was short. It was a swing a long way, but it came lovely, came right into Taylor, just helped it over square leg. But it was beautifully struck.
Really, Mike Slater is he's a model batsman to watch for any youngsters. Only a young man himself, not tall, but footwork beautiful to watch.
and a batsman who simply will not be dictated to by a bowler. Just having a look from our stump camera, there's straight down the wicket. And again, and this time it's four runs, railing with me, and he's a very good young player, though.
Yes, he's very quick on his feet, gets into position to play all the shots. He's very quick to come down the wicket to the spinners, and there you saw a perfect example of the cover drive. Again, just a little chassé down and crack through that extra covered area. Beautiful shot.
There's four more. And as he's trying to tempt the man into the drive, he'll probably be disappointed such that that got through mid off as well. Again, an example of footwork and timing. The slow outfield's robbed him. He'll still get three. Copy of a shot a couple of overs ago, and again it's the footwork that makes that.
Well, there's nothing wrong with the delivery, just outside off stump, good length, lovely footwork by Slater, and really timed that shot well.
And this is a pedigree shot to bring up the 150. There's the footwork, a pace and a half down and completely to the pitcher ball. That 150's come off 48 overs. Oh, that was a good one. Taylor was prepared to take him on, but it was the right line, and that's really what aborted the stroke.
It was straight. Made the batsman think about hooking, but then he had to get his face and his mask out of the way.
All the nines, or rather two of them. Now everybody will be in the starting traps, certainly the non-striker, Mark Taylor, 99. What a moment for the young man. 162 now. And there it is. Wonderful, punches the air, the dressing room will acknowledge, the crowd will, and you just won't see a better 100 than that.
Well, a very elated young man, and thoroughly deserved the reception from the crowd and from his teammates. He played wonderfully well.
There it is. Every sign of jubilation and history made in every way, because 100 there, 163 now without loss. That's Australia's highest opening partnership on the ground.
Cracking shot, and over a slow outfielder, still beats the fielder by a good dozen yards there, deep third man. Well, that's one of the stronger shouts we've had in the day's play. For LBW, it's Mark Taylor.
Well, Philip Tufnell bowling down the slope, over the wicket. It's a shout, but did it pitch outside?
Well, it's all food and drink, I'm afraid, to
Mark Taylor, when you drop as short as that on a slow pitch?
Well, you can take your choice on this. It's an attempted bouncer, or it's a long hop.
Philip Tufnell has bowled 5 overs so far for 27. It's 179 for no wicket. Comes in out from the nursery end. Oh, he's scythed away by Slater. Slater gets into position and then he really whacks the bat into it. Terrific physical effort.
Well, this is just pure confidence of a man relaxed after getting 100 and he just whacks it into the stand.
That's well bowled.
Well, you can either give credit to the bowler here or to the batsman just losing concentration. That's a long way outside off stump. Just feeling for it.
Oh, there we are. You hear the applause? Glasses are being raised in the stand and hands put together. It's a major moment. Really, it was a bit wide, that, for somebody who's been in as long as Mark Taylor. Oh, he's picked it up. Beautifully from outside off stump. And Mark Taylor playing the sweep shot from outside off stump. He gets his legs and his body in the way, so there's no way he can be bowled. And, well, the sweep man that they've got out there is very fine, so that's a pretty safe shot to hit it square. Oh, then that's another beautiful stroke. Again, superb footwork is the key to it all, and the 200 comes up. And this is the first time that Australian openers have put up a 200 partnership in a Lord's Test match.
Slower ball and he picked it perfectly. The most glorious stroke away through cover play.
Yes, that was really good cricket. Quite a good slower ball from Foster there. They really waited for that. You could see him and then just timed it through the covers. See the hesitation and then the lovely follow through.
Simply cannot afford to miss chances, particularly if a bowler who has had 51 taken from his first 8 overs.
That was a good delivery. It wasn't the easiest ball to take. It spun a long way, came through the gate, over the top of the stumps. And it certainly wasn't the easiest to take. It did have a little bit of room to see it as the Taylor went down the pitch.
Is Slater facing Tufnell. Beautiful spin. He's a wonderful late cutter, Michael Slater. Don't see the shot all that often these days because of the slowness of the pitches, but this is quite a slow pitch, and he's played that perfectly.
Well, it might be a slow pitch, but it certainly didn't go slow once it played the shot. Beautifully timed, and the body right over the shot.
They were there at lunch and they're still there at tea. 86 to Taylor, 120 not out to Slater. That's a magnificent innings. 212 for no wicket and 6 extras in that total. A fine performance from those two men and no joy at all for the bowlers. 38 off Caddick and 57 off Foster. Tufnell harshly dealt with. He'll need some reserves of strength to come back from that. 11 overs, 1 maiden and no wicket for 56. We join play after tea in the second over. 2 runs have been added. Chris Lewis is the bowler, and Michael Slater is taking strike.
That's well stopped.
Peter Such has had a busy day in the field.
Well, his lovely feeling, a lovely shot here. The bat going very straight again, right through the ball. great fielding, and Mark Taylor, the non-striker, their ball watching, saying yes, no, no, yes, dancing, and nearly a run out. If Peter Sutch could have got up a little quicker, which was difficult for him, but Mark Taylor committing the sin of ball watching. Well, that was a very unusual delivery. That almost crept along the ground. That kept very low. Mark Taylor couldn't quite believe this. It kept down, rebouncing twice, nearly three times to Alex Stewart. He played underneath it and around it. That goes on the inside, but it's because it kept low.
Bread and butter shot for Taylor. Not good running from Slater to turn it into three. 2-1-8 now for no wicket. Lewis now to Taylor.
Well, this is one of the few genuine mistakes. The drive, the inside edge past the stumps. Haven't been many genuine mistakes from the Australian batsman today.
Lewis to Slater. Wonderful shot. He got everything. Placement and timing.
Yes, what made the shot, he saw it early, he saw the length. He was in position very quickly.
Lewis now to Taylor. Certainly Lewis has bothered Mark Taylor a couple of times since tea.
Yes, Chris Lewis is striving for a bit of extra pace, and he seems to have upset Mark Taylor's rhythm. Made him play a miss a couple of times.
And Slater playing delightful strokes like that. He's thrilled this Lord's crowd. That's a wonderful shot.
Well, these batsmen have picked England off all day. Just a nice, low, juicy, full toss. And he's picked the gap on the onside.
They're top shots. All the way through, he picks the length so quickly, and his timing is so good. His 15th four.
Yes, he's pretty quickly into position because he's got good footwork and he's just as comfortable off the front or back foot.
Well, you heard Jack Bannister say how quickly Slater picks up the length. And I can see how the words twinkle toes come out of the writer's pen now and again. That was quick. Half back, that's his first step, and then the readjustment. It's all balanced, though. There's no shifting of weight, just a settling of feet, really. Slower ball, and Slater just waiting then, just running up down. 250 comes up, and automatic applause. As Ian says, the England supporters in the crowd have cheered with the balls past the bat, but they haven't held back with applause. I think they've appreciated that they've seen very, very good batting and sometimes quite brilliant batting, and especially from Michael Slater. And that's it. It was a no ball, but Taylor ran the ball back at the square on the offside, and that's his 10th test match century. And his second in two tests in this series. So he's set a terrific example for Australia in this 1993 Ashes series, much appreciated by all his teammates.
.252 for no wickets. Once again, Slater showing that good footwork can quickly get you into position for front or back foot. Chris Lewis just giving him a little bit of width there, and he was quickly onto that back foot.
Slater moves on to 150. Waves to the dressing room, as is the habit these days. Leaves the helmet on this time. When he got his century, it was wonderful to see. Punching in the air, the helmet was off. I think he kissed the helmet.
I think it was actually the badge that he was kissing, Tony.
There's no accounting for taste, is there? But now he's mature, he's a senior player now, 150, just a wave of the bat. It's got him, and that is the area where England have been half expecting a catch. That firm push on the onside, but this quite beautiful and often brutal innings of 152 by Michael Slater has ended. He'll be sad, he'll be happy, there'll be a mixture of emotions, but I bet it's a very comfortable bath he's heading for. Standing ovation at Lord's in his first test match. That's a great moment, Ian.
Yes, and he's a young man who knows a bit about the history of test cricket, and it looked to me almost as though he was sort of taking it all in there as he looked around the ground, just enjoying the moment, whilst no batsman ever likes getting out. If you've got to get out, it's nice to have 150 against your name, and when it's your first test match at Lord's, I think most of the emotions will be happiness. Thoughtful piece of bowling there from Chris Lewis, coming around the wicket. He was looking for the catch in that onside area, and the catch taken by the substitute fielder.
David Boone comes in, no doubt, glowering with determination as usual. And what a relief it must have been for young Ben Smith, the substitute fielder. Here you are, get called down from Leicestershire, sticking out in the test match to field in front of a packed house at Lord's.
Well, short again by Lewis, and Taylor hooking that away down to the fine leg boundary. Banged in well short, but down the leg side as well. The batsman was naturally in position to play the shot and playing it pretty well.
There have been just a few edges and things that haven't quite gone right today. Tuttle's had one chance missed. I think that was excessive spin. It was just that David Boone got the leading edge around.
And well bowled. Good test of temperament for Phil Tufnell, and he stood up to it. His fans gave him some real hammer early on, and now he struck back with just about 35 minutes to go to stumps, and he's had Taylor stumped after having him missed in the same way by Stewart earlier in the day.
Yeah.
Well, that will give Philip Tufnell a little bit of confidence, which he was short of. See, the difference between that and the other one was that went on the outside edge, bounced a nice height, more or less stump high, and the wicketkeeper would see that the whole way through. The previous one turned, went between bat and pad and over the top of the stumps, and that a much easier chance.
New batsman is Mark Waugh. Pierced the field beautifully there, David Boone. Ben Smith followed the chase there. Caddick was the first fielder. He is such a strong cutter. Beautiful player, square of the wicket. Strong off his pads as well, but square of the wicket on the offside. Just first class. That's a good fighting effort from England in the last session of play. They've kept the Australians down below 300, 292 for two, 12 extras in the total there. And the men out, Taylor 111, Slater for a magnificent 152. Boone and Mark Waugh were playing for the clock and the close of play through the taking of the second new ball towards the end. And the bowling figures for England, well, that looks a little better. Tufnell did come back, and he came back very well indeed. 15 overs, two maidens, one for 65. A good effort from him. And Lewis, 15 overs, one maiden, one for 57. No joy for the others. It was a dead track, but the batting was absolutely top class all the way through.
Over of the day, Lewis is the